Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids across our beloved empire. If you haven't said it before, you're going to say it today. It's great to be in the empire today, especially with Mara Jade, the Emperor's Hand, officially in Galaxy Heroes. And in this video, we are going to be doing an initial gameplay review of Mara Jade. I think the consensus is across the board, this character is serious, and I'm extremely happy to say, unlike a lot of characters in Galaxy Heroes, this character has a lot of 3-star viability. That's right, everyone gets Mara Jade for free at 3 stars, and she can pretty much do everything that a 7-star variant can do, to the point where she, at 3 stars, can help Palpatine and Vader take out General Anakin Skywalker, and it seems like as well she's going to be another option for the Palpatine Wat Tambor Darth Vader lineup to take out Jedi Master Luke Skywalker. Although taking out Jedi Master Luke Skywalker with Palpatine and Wat Tambor isn't anything new, she's giving you new opportunities to use her versus the GLs, and she's great with the GLs, as we're going to talk about with Lord Vader. And I think on top of it all, even though she's great with Palpatine, we're going to show her she's great outside of Emperor Palpatine as well, bringing things like Thrawn Lead as well as Director Krennic Lead to some pretty good life. And you know what's also going to breathe some life into me right now? Gary, can you hit it for me, baby? Now! Hey, yeah, you, come here. What if I told you that not all mobile games just release expensive several $100 characters? And what if I told you they actually have brand new game modes and content to provide you? Well, then let me introduce you to our sponsor, Raid Shadow Legends! If you want to take part in one of the greatest mobile games of all time, use the links down below. This month in Raid, there is a huge update which introduces a brand new boss, the Hydra. And if you're brave enough to take out the Hydra, you'll be rewarded with some of the greatest rewards that Raid Shadow Legends has to offer. A little pro tip. It bleeds, and if it bleeds, you can kill it! And if a whole brand new raid boss isn't enough for you, well, there's more I can tell you what's happening this month. They are actually giving away a free, super limited champion in Raid based off an eSport legend and Navi superstar. Simple! And between now and January 28th, if you log in for 7 days, you too can get this character for free. Yeah, not $400. And on top of that, Raid is celebrating the holiday festivities with tons of events, so get on over before you miss out on all the fun. Hit the link in the description or scan my QR code and you'll get an epic champion, Aina, 200,000 silver, 1 energy refill, and 1 XP boost, and 1 ancient shard. All this treasure will be waiting for you right up here, but you gotta be quick because these rewards are only available for the next 30 days. You know, I gotta say, it's great getting back on track with characters that are useful. Dark Town kind of threw a kink in our testing this year because she was a character that didn't really get a lot of love right now. I think she might have a bigger future down the road, but Mara Jade has a big future right now, and it's only going to get bigger. Of course, if you don't know at this point, she is the 4th and last requirement for Starkiller. In my opinion, 3 out of the 4 are fantastic characters so far from what I've seen, and you're going to see a mostly 3-star footage today. We did a stream yesterday, put a card in the top right-hand corner, and I said out the get-go, guys, I think she's going to have a lot of low-star viability because, yes, although she's branded an attacker, I kind of saw her as like a Bast of Shaan Fallen with all the demos and direct synergy with Emperor Palpatine. And the long story short of it is, if she gets a turn with one of her AoEs, either one, the train just starts rolling. And I know that she's got a territory Omicron, which we will talk about in a moment here, but in Grand Arena, if she can jump the gun and get out before you, you might never catch up again. And that's the moral of the story. And it's crazy that before we started 7-star testing, I was like, all right, let's just try General Anakin Skywalker. And right out the gate, they were beating General Anakin Skywalker consistently. Palpatine, Vader, Thrawn, Mara Jade, and I really feel like you're going to need Gideon to make it work, to get the moralize applied, to make sure you can outrun Captain Rex, because it's very hard for Mara Jade to outrun a properly modded Captain Rex with Gideon in the crew. It was very consistent. Now, the great thing is Gideon, his only other best use really is with the Bounty Hunters to counter General Anakin Skywalker, so it's actually not a lot to say put Gideon with Emperor Palpatine, because that's kind of one of his best uses is to outrun Captain Rexes and counter General Anakin Skywalkers that exist out there. And a lot of people have already Moff Gideon unlocked for free when you start the game, and he just officially became a 2-for-1 double drop character. And we tried using it without Gideon. It's a little bit trickier to beat Gas without Gideon, but I don't think it's actually asking for a lot to throw Gideon in that lineup. The only thing that was consistent is when Gas does his final stand, it's a messy battle, but we always pushed on through whenever we got to that situation there. And I think this is great. This is 3-star and 7-star practically the same thing that's going on here. And this is incredibly important as well, because Mara Jade at 3-stars Gillen, she doesn't have as much speed as she normally would have otherwise. She is the third fastest non-Galactic Legend character in the game base speed-wise with 192, but that's at 7-stars. When you're in 3-star, you're losing about 20-some speed, and you can't get access to 6-stop mods. So majority of this gameplay, she's not even in the 300s. She's like in the 290s, and as long as she gets a turn out there, you're going to start just rolling circles around him. And usually Vader can help a 3-star Mara Jade keep him, because he gets tons of bonus speed when there's enemy Rebel and Jedi and Imperial and Sith on his team. I want to talk about this. This is also noteworthy to an extent. Palpatine was already able to beat Jedi Master Luke Skywalker, which is why you never see me play Jedi Master Luke Skywalker on defense, because it opens up the possibility of Palpatine with Darth Revan, or just Darth Revan lead with Wat Tambor. They can just run circles around Jedi Master Luke Skywalker. Jedi Master Luke Skywalker, even in the best lineup, isn't the greatest defensive team because it's easy to outrun him. Well, let's say you don't have Darth Revan, and let's say you have Mara Jade, or you want to use Darth Revan somewhere else. The good thing about this, the thing to pull out of this, is that Mara Jade can replace Darth Revan, although you have to wait a little bit because she gets ability blocked out the get-go. She's kind of useless for about 2 turns until the ability block drops off. But once that ability block drops off and she starts getting debuffs going, you're just they never can catch up. You're just constantly getting tons and tons of Terminator. You're slowing down the enemy team. You're stun locking them. You're dispelling buffs on them. So I think that's another great thing to point out. As you're seeing here, you can beat Jedi Master Luke with the same lineup, more or less, with Darth. And so it's not surprising that Palpatine can beat Jedi Master Luke Skywalker with Mara Jade. I don't think that's the main takeaway here. I think the main takeaway is her Empire synergy, making a lot of Imperial lineups great, even at 3-stars. And she's also an unaligned Force user. And as you're seeing right now, if you don't have Maul, which is obviously the superior Lord Vader lineup, I think she's going to be the second best unaligned dark side Force user that we have now. And she's also Empire, so that's great that she's at least not just some random like Maul that doesn't really he doesn't like Lord Vader to begin with from a lore perspective. But simply being an unaligned dark side Force user does wonders for Lord Vader, because as you know, if you have an unaligned dark side Force user, whether that's Maul, Mara Jade, Kylo Ren baby, Kylo Ren unmasked, Asajj Ventress, there's a couple of other ones that you can maybe suggest for that matter. You're reducing unaligned Force users, light side unaligned Force users damage, which is great for countering a Commander Ahsoka Tano's. And it's more importantly, as you're seeing here, it works very well up against Rey lineups. And the coolest thing about this that I think, as you're seeing right here, Mara Jade, when she's not with Emperor Palpatine, she applies a useful pawn, which is that red status effect, which oddly enough, I believe has an interesting interaction with Thrawn lead. Because when Thrawn lead, if he gets debuffs applied to his team, they gain Terminator. So it seems like that useful pawn that applies is counted as a debuff, I believe, and therefore feeds a little bit of Terminator to Thrawn lead at the beginning. So it's a nice little mechanic to keep in mind. But the most important thing is when there's no Palpatine, you apply useful pawn, which does debuff the team to a very minor extent, pulling back some of their offense critical chance, only 5%. It's not a lot, and she gains 10% as a result. But with useful pawn, anytime she's using her basic, she's going to call a random ally with useful pawn to assist. If Palpatine was in the lead, she would always call Palpatine to assist. But it was really cool because in a Lord Vader lineup, almost anyone is kind of a nice person to assist. Getting Darth Vader to assist, you get the ability blocks. Royal Guard, you might get a stun. Lord Vader has a good basic. But one thing that's really cool is she can call in Piet for the assist. Piet also calls an Imperial ally to assist, or the character he threw under the bus with inevitable failure. So sometimes you can get this awesome chain of Mara Jade, Piet, Lord Vader to assist. And then some people are saying maybe that's going to be a great 3v3 team. Time will tell. But nonetheless, point being is if you don't want to use it for Emperor Palpatine for whatever reason, I think she's going to be one of the best replacements for a dark side unaligned Force user for the Lord Vader lineup. Should make those raid battles easier. We couldn't quite get her to beat Master Kenobi unless you got Maul on the team, because Maul needs to increase those cooldowns on Commander Ahsoka Tano right out the get-go. But the rest of this gameplay you're going to see here, it's primarily 3-star gameplay and a little bit of funny conquest gameplay towards the very end. Yes, countering Jedi Master Luke Skywalker is cool. Gives you some flexibility to Palpatine to get Darth Revan out of the lineup. Yes, it's great at 3 and 7 stars. She can counter General Anakin Skywalker. But I think also what you're going to see here is a variety of other type of team compositions.
Krennicleed, for example, absolutely loves debuffs, because anytime you're critically hitting a debuffed enemy, yeah, you're getting protection back, but you're guaranteed to get ability blocked, and you just keep the whole entire enemy team on complete lockdown. So she's going to give you lots of flexibility with Palpatine, just getting those debuffs out there nonstop, turn meter train. Thrawn, lots of protection going on there, and also at the same time, she's feeding some debuffs, calling people to assist. Great in that situation. Krennic is going to be another funny example. So the point being is, yes, her primary use is Palpatine and Vader. They're coming back to the top, baby. He has returned, but you're going to have flexibility to use her in a lot of other areas inside of the game. I want to wrap up with this point. We, even though I love it, initial impressions are great. One thing I like about this character, just like Dash Rendar and Kyle Katarn, you don't need the Omicron to make her great. Darth Talon wasn't great before the Omicron. Maybe she's going to be great with Omicron in Grand Arena. Time will tell in that regard. But Mara Jade does need the Omicron to be useful outside of the territories. But let's talk about that, because I would be remiss if I didn't tell you what we're missing here. She has an Omicron on the Emperor's Hand, her unique ability, which grants Empire allies extra offense and extra potency, which is great for getting those debuffs to apply with Infiltrate and Disrupt. But she seems like she is going to be a General Anakin Skywalker killer, which is very prevalent in Territory Wars. And a lot of top guilds, they're like, all right, people, we need you to get this right now in regards to the Emperor's Hand. What happens in Territory Wars at the start of the battle if the leader is not a Galactic Legend? They instantly lose 100% protection and lose 50% max protection. And Mara Jade gains 100% turn meter right out the get-go. So she could be the slowest character in existence. She will outrun every Captain Rex, even if it's the fastest Captain Rex in existence. Can't outrun Han Solo. Do note that. And she's also going to basically, in general, if she's moving 100% protection, gas instantly sits down. So as you saw earlier, a 3-star Mara Jade was able to counter General Anakin Skywalker in an arena, squad arena type of setting, or just before the Omicron in general. Now imagine if she could just make him sit down right away. It's basically like a Sith Eternal situation, where Sith Eternal makes gas kneel after a few turns, and then he can't do anything until the rest of his 501st allies get defeated. So that's what I'm trying to get at, is that we're not seeing everything, and I think she is going to be one of the most important characters to use in a territory war situation with it. And if your guild is serious about territories, I think Grand Arena is more important right now, but I know my guild, they're urging us to save our Omicrons solely for territories, and they want us to save them for Mara Jade. And it seems like Boba Fett's sign of Jango as well. Serious character, a lot of fun, and I think really at the end of the day, I'm just happy she's going to be viable at 3 stars, because everyone can take advantage of her for the time being in their roster. To wrap this up, let's quickly talk about the mods as well as the Zetas, if they're needed or not. Now, with the mods, I think the most important thing you need to know is that obviously it's about getting her debuffs to apply, making sure she gets out there, get debuffs to apply, and once they start applying, Palpatine gains Terminator, she's getting tons of Terminator. It's game, set, match. And it seems like in any sort of situation, Grand Arena territory, she's going to open up with one of these AoEs, which applies a lot of debuffs right out the get-go, which is going to allow her to transition into another turn and another turn and another turn, as well as Zephyr Palpatine. So you really need to get those debuffs to apply for Infiltrate and Disrupt and also Predator, but you also want her to be as fast as possible to get out there. And if you're running her at low stars, you definitely want to make sure you have some focus on durability. It's funny, even though she's an attacker, we didn't talk once about her damage. She does have adequate damage. Actually, I think she got more damage than Darth Talon most of the time. And she wasn't sold as a high single fire burst damage character, or whatever the case might be. Speed set is going to be the way to go. You could argue to put some potency down there or protection to make her more durable. I recommend potency because if she can't get the debuffs to apply, which is pretty rare, she pretty much got her debuffs to apply all the time. But if in the case it doesn't happen, she's not going to be as you're not going to get as much Terminator fed to your team out there. We rocked her in a variety of speed levels from 330 to 360. At the 3 stars, she's only at 292. So no matter what, speed seems to be the way to go. And durability, health and protection is going to be the other way to go. Maybe she's got more damage, but I think for me personally, the way I'm treating her as a mega support character, she needs to stay alive, needs to be fast, and she needs to make sure she lands as many debuffs as possible, because her base potency is a little bit on the low side. But when you consider the fact Emperor's Hand grants extra potency in her unique ability, and you also consider the fact that things, for example, like Emperor Palpatine, which is going to be her main bread and butter for the most part, also gets potency boost, you might not need to stress out as much about the potency, especially if 35% potency, 20% potency on her unique ability. You're going to get by, but I think it's better be safe than sorry. Throw some potency on that cross. Make sure those debuffs land, and this baby's going to connect the dots. And man, all I could say is all aboard the Palpatine Express, ladies and gentlemen. It is back in service. And lastly, very quickly, Zetas. I actually don't know if I recommend Altered Predator. She's a 2-Zeta Marquee character, which is a bit on the rare side. We don't see a lot of 2-Zeta Marquee characters. I see her more as a support. I don't really see her as an attacker, so this isn't important for me. I honestly wish I can get it back. I'm sure in some situations it might be nice getting that extra damage. This is 1,000%. I think her primary use is going to be Emperor Palpatine, and to ensure that that turn meter train never stops, whether going to be against General Anakin Skywalker, Jedi Master Luke, or whatever other teams you might throw it against, you want to make sure you're maximizing that relationship between Palpatine, Mara Jade, and getting that extra turn meter for each debuff being inflicted, and that's going to be a ton. As we see with all the offense down, shocks, and staggers being applied, mwah! Fantastic Zeta for her. This is great for everyone. If you're a guy with not a lot of great characters out there, Palpatine and Vader is a staple team in this game. If you can eke out a General Anakin Skywalker win, whew, that's beautiful. But for me especially, Emperor Palpatine, Lord Vader, Darth Vader, not really important for high-end gameplay. This is going to change the game. Mara Jade is a slam dunk character, and I think there's a lot more for us to learn. Ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and Droids, thank you so much for stopping by today. Leave a like, comment down below. I know your thoughts. Dang, I love this character. See, I can be positive about the game. Do something good. Release a solid 3-star character. You're going to get some high remarks from me. And you know what else is going to get a high remark? All of you guys, because yet again, it's great to be in the Empire today.